Hello everyone, and welcome back to Wicked Art. It's Wicked here, and today we're going to learn something that a lot of people tend to struggle with when drawing characters, and we're going to learn how to break down the hand and then draw it into a full complete hand, okay? So all you need is a pencil, an eraser, and we'll get started. Okay. So when we look at the hand, no matter what position you want to put it in, I usually start with a square shape or a rectangular shape. Just depends how big the hand is. Okay, so we're just going to sketch ourselves out a little stretched out square a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to darken that up so you guys can see it a little better. Okay, so that's the simple part. Next part we want to do is just depending on the side, so I'm going to put the thumb on this side. Okay, we want to break the fingers down into shapes. Okay, so like for our thumb, if you look at your thumb, we have these big shape right in here, and we have these little lines that can kind of help us break it down. So there's nothing wrong with taking pictures of your hand or pulling up pictures of people's hands. Okay, but we're going to go ahead and draw in that shape of the thumb there. Okay, and then we just want to do, so when it comes to the thumb, we want to put this like curve here, and then you want that fat part on the tip. We're just going to kind of round it there, and we can bring that down into that piece there. So see, now we've got a thumb. Okay, now we're going to put some bends in the fingers. So what we're going to do is we're going to break it down into sections. We're going to do that first piece. Okay, now I'm going to have my finger a little bit forward, so we're going to do all that first section above in the knuckle. Okay, I'm going to put like a little fingernail in there, if that'll help you remember. Okay, and we have that piece that goes underneath right there off the finger, and we have our bottom piece right here. Okay, so think of it like this hand is just doing a complex pose. Okay, so usually when I'm bending fingers and they're coming more towards me, I always start with that top piece. So we're going to go ahead and draw another one in. Okay, so think of it kind of like a bean shape. Okay, so we'll draw another nail in there. And we can draw that next section. Right back in here. Okay. Maybe widen it out just a little bit. Alright. So I'm going to come down here with another one. So it's almost like it's closing. So I'll make this other bean shape right here. And then we're just going to put in another nail for reference. Okay, we can stretch this one back a little bit more. Have that go back. Alright. And then, whenever the next piece right next to it, I'm going to put it, make it more of like a dynamic image. So I'm going to make it have a little turn to it. Okay. And I'm going to come back and add the next section like that, and then your hand kind of curves out, so we want to add like a little curve to it right here, and then we want to round now, so we're going to kind of start again with that. So see how we curved out? We want to kind of bend it in and come right back out again and curve that under. Okay. And we can kind of stretch across and go over to our thumb like this. Now we can come in here, kind of clean up the lines in there. Okay, so we want to put a couple little dividing lines for our thumb. I'm going to stretch this out probably a little bit more. Okay, we can erase that old square line in there. And then with the rest of our hands, I'm just going to go through now and add in some lines and just refine. Seeing. So you can see this hand starting to take shape. You can probably see a little bit of the thumbnail right up here like that. Okay, same thing with this piece up here that's dividing it. We can just erase that line out and then come in here and just kind of put in these little detailed lines like what you see on your hand. Down here. I'm going to come in and refine this shape. Again, I don't want that going all the way across. We just did that just so we could build up the shape. Okay. And just build that up like that. I'm going to come over to our pinky here. Let's put a curve in there and erase that old line that connects it across. In there. And if you wanted to, just for a little extra, add another line right in there. It's not too bad, right? Obviously, I could go in here and I could adjust things. Like I could come down here and maybe round that hand out just a little bit more. And that's up to you and what you see and how your character is going to look. But for the most part, that's, you know, that basic build. Okay. So we can do another one. Let's do one where we have a kind of facing away. So I'm going to go in here. Okay. And I'm going to build out my square shape. Okay. Again, I like to start with the thumb. So I'm going to build up my shape right here. As I have it as a reference, okay. So I'm going to come out, I'm going to add this big curve onto the thumb, go ahead and cut that off, like that. See how it's broken down into sections? Again, if I wanted to, put a little line in there just to know that that's a nail shape, okay. So the next thing, our hand's going to be stretched out this way. So what I can do is I can just go ahead and just break it down into shapes. Now we do have that kind of a bump off, so I'm just going to kind of break it down that way. Okay. And we're just going to go section by section of the finger. If you notice on the far edges, excuse me, on the far edges I'm just putting in curves to just kind of give it more of a dynamic angle. Put in my little nail shape here. Okay. Now, when you spread your fingers apart like this, you see how you have that little bit of skin that kind of connects right in there? So we want to give that, okay? So we want to kind of put like a slight curve before we go to the next finger. And then we'll just break that down into sections. Now remember, if you look at your hand, your pinky is longest out of all of them, so you want to kind of go above the last line that you just did. Okay. And you're just going to essentially build out the same shapes again, just a little bit longer than the last. Okay, I'm going to stretch that out. Shape here. Alright. So next one, we're gonna just kind of make our finger a little bit closer together. So our arc, so if I close this hand up, you see how the arc closes down, right? It's not, it's more pinched off. So we just need a little slight curve right in there. Okay, now it's the ring finger, it's a little bit shorter, so we're not gonna go as long. We are gonna do the same shapes. Thickness of that finger there. So let's bring this a little bit closer. Like that. Okay, again, I'm just going to put in a little nail shape there. Alright, and then I'm really going to spread out my pinky. But remember, we have knuckles on our fingers, so that can kind of block the way. So that's why I'm putting in this little hump here. So I know where to start my pinky. I'm going to spread that out, bring that in, like that, okay, and I'm just going to stretch that out into three sections as well. Alright, now we're going to kind of, since our knuckle's going this way, it's leading into like a bend in the wrist. So we can pull that up and go back with it. Okay. Down here by our thumb, because our wrist wraps around, and kind of put a little curve here for our wrist and connect at the thumb like that. And then just drop that back. Okay, so we can probably skinny this one up a little bit, like that, okay. And now I'm just going to do like I did before. I'm just going to leave some line work in there. So those little division points that I have, I'm just going to put lines and just refine my hand. Just going to go around and go back over my hand lines. Okay, so now I can get rid of this area here. Alright, so see how that built up that thumb? So when you break things down in shapes, it makes it a whole lot easier. Okay, so now we've come this way. I'm going to take that curve and I'm going to erase that corner. But I am going to put a slight knuckle shape in there. Okay, and again, I'm just going to erase out those middle lines. Okay, and at any point, I can come in here and add my finger shape. So I'm going to add a little bit more of a curve to the ends of my fingers. Start looking like that. And again, you can make adjustments. If that's too skinny of a hand, you want to do a thicker one, that's fine. Just go back into all over the top of it. Just erase it out. You at least have the base shape in there. Okay. So, a couple lines in there. I'm going to add one right there. Put one up here at the top. Curve that around. You're just going to keep working in there, erase out the middle, and get that little extra line out of there too, because we want those fingers to be touching. So I'm just going to curve that around, and just cleaning up all that sketchiness that's in there. And then we just have our pinky. So we'll go ahead just refine it like that. Okay? So that's another hand. And like I said, you can do things like, you can take pictures of your hands in different poses, you can hold it up in front of you, or just pull up images of a hand. Okay? So we're going to do another one. Alright, so again, I'm going to do another dynamic shape, so I'm just going to come in here. Square shape. Alright. And again, I'm going to start with the thumb. So I'm going to round right off of here. And we're going to add in our curve right here. Kind of similar to like the one we did before. But we're going to turn the fingers a little bit. See right, a little bit of the nail right here. Okay. So we have this part of our hand, but I'm going to bend the fingers in more forward from the middle. So I'm actually going to start with the middle finger here because I want that to be closest to the thumb. So I'm going to build up that shape first. Got my first little bean right there. Okay, so this is another method that you can use. You can do all the tips of the fingers first if you want, and then just go back. So like I can come out here, get my bean shape again, so you can remember what they are. You can add in the little shape of a nail. Pinky close by, have it stretch this way. So do another bean shape right here. Get our nail. Okay. So all my fingers that are close to the thumb, we're going to go ahead and build those up. So I'm going to do the next section. I'll come out. Round that in. And we come out to our knuckle. One. Build out that section. It's a little bit further stretched out. And just so you guys can see that better, I'm going to go ahead and clean up the inside that area. Okay, and then that's going to stretch back. A little bit of a knuckle there. Okay, I'm going to take my pinky back. Finger to do. So I'm going to run that up a little bit higher over here. Got my little bean shape. Okay, take that and stretch it back to the other knuckle, and we can just cut that off right there. We got all three of our fingers, right? So now, from this angle, since we can see more of it and it's turned, you have that ball right here on your wrist. So we don't have to draw that whole shape. We can just take it and form the shape like that. Okay? Then the rest of it you can build around with and curve that up just like that. Okay? So now I can build out my thumb right in there like that. So now I can go ahead and clean up that whole inside area. Then go in and add my finger details. Okay, so we don't want that line touching, so we're just going to leave it separate just a little bit. Okay. Again, just go through to the next finger, erase those inside lines out. A couple finger lines in there, just refine the rest of it. Okay. So I'm going to go back. Find my line in here. Finger. Some lines coming off the top here. Let's clean up that bottom part there. So this part right here, we don't want it to touch, so we're just going to separate it just a little bit. Just so we have that curve so we can see the turn. Okay? Again, we got our last finger. Okay, so we're going to turn that out. And bring that up. Just round that finger off. Okay? So I'm going to refine the rest of this. I'm going to put a curve here and run my thumb down just a little. Just make that solid right there. Okay? So if you wanted to, again, we could come down here. We could disconnect down here at the bottom. Bring that in. Right? Wrist in here, just for practice, okay? So I'm going to do one more, alright? I'm going to come in here, draw my square, okay? Now if you notice, I'm kind of angling it out some because we're going to do more of a dynamic pose. You can kind of help set up your fingers that way. I'm going to start with my thumb shape. Okay, so I'm going to turn the thumb down this way. So you can see the shape better. I'm just going to erase the inside of it. Alright. Then from there, I'm just going to kind of come out. Shape there. Okay. I'm going to pull that up. I'm going to stretch out a little. Slight bend here. Okay. And then we're going to break that down into sections. So I'm going to do this first piece here. A little bit thicker. And stretch it out one more. And put a big curve in it. This next one, the way we're going to have the finger kind of facing us, so I'm going to start with the tip of the finger, okay? I'm going to put a slight turn to it, but it'll be the tip of the finger, okay? So it's kind of like bent up like this, okay? So I'm going to bring the rest of that down into the hand like that, okay? And we'll kind of run a knuckle shape off the back like this. Okay, so we're just breaking that down like that. So we got a slight curve. Okay, now the other one, just remember you have that spread, so we want to kind of curve that out. I'm going to come up and make a knuckle. Okay, I'm going to break that down into shapes. Bend in it. Okay, see a little bit of it right here, of that nail. Okay, Okay, so I'm gonna clean up that inside area right here so you can see it look like that. So I'm doing like a super dramatic like bend. So that means over here for my pinky, I'm gonna see part of the knuckle. It's gonna curve down. Break that down into shapes, right? And then since we have that there, we know that our muscle right here is gonna be curving in, about right here. Okay, we can also add probably another line right there and then just clean up the inside. So it should look like that, okay? And we can take this area of the thumb. So we have that, we can kind of split that just for some definition. Okay, so we can just leave this kind of shape right here. And then just leave that disconnected like that. Okay, so now I'm going to go through and I'm going to put those lines in. So our finger one's pretty good set up. Index finger. Okay. And I'm going to split down the middle. A slight curve across, maybe an extra line right here. And we're going to arch this part. Bring the thumb out in front of that. Okay. So, my thumb, same thing. I'm just going to refine that. Little extra lines in there. Just erase out this part. Down and put an extra line here. Okay, same with this finger here. You just clean that out. Put that in. Probably adjust the finger a little. Let's cut it down. See, I cut down on the corner. Still has that sharp end. I'm just rounding that corner off. That way it'll look more like a finger. Okay, now we just put that down there. We'll come in here to this finger. Okay, we're going to use that curve to put a bend. Okay, put a little line here for the knuckle here. Finger. Again, I'm going to come out, a little shape here, this bottom of the finger here, just refine that a little bit more. Okay. Then, just come down, and make our wrist. Okay. So that's the basics of drawing hand. Okay, so I hope that you take this. You're not going to master hands after just watching this video, okay? Just because you did four doesn't mean you're good to go. But the more you draw it, the better you're going to get at it, okay? So, for your homework, I would say spend the week drawing four or five hands every day, okay? And then just keep going from there and watch how much you grow and then how much it's saved in your memory, alright? So, go ahead and practice that. I hope you learned something. I hope you had fun. And until the next video, keep sketching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.